Elgon Group table leaders Maroons FC will seek revenge against Chitezi Bayside Wandega Football Club in a battle where both teams need at least a point.
I think we're prepared enough for the second round, though in the second round most teams are going to be very, very difficult because everybody now knows what they're looking for. Others want promotion, others want to stay in the league, others are fighting the drop. So everybody is going to be playing at their best to make sure that they achieve their aim. So we have put a lot of effort to make sure that we can maintain our leadership in the league and maintain the 5-point advantage that we have over a second team.
In their first round encounter, Wandega FC salvaged 3 points after Maroons FC fielded a non-licensed player named Kamada Luvega. Wandega FC is battling relegation after losing most of their key players they had signed at the beginning of the season.
Our target at the beginning of the season was to get promotion to the big league, to the Premier Division, and we are still working on that. We are saying if we don't qualify automatically, at least we go to the playoffs. Now that they have injected money into the league, every team is fighting to get there. But certainly we are playing a very strong opponent in Maroons. We respect them, but we are not afraid of them. We are ready for them tomorrow.
Maroons FC are leading the Elgon group with 23 points after 11 games, while Wandega FC is in 8th position with 14 points. In some of the other games, Masaka LC will host Chireka United, Creamland play Proline, Chirinya Jinja face Kasese, while Busia United host VCC. In the Rwenzori group, Baza Holdings take on Water FC, Soreti Garage play CRO, Sporting United host Spider Black Angels, while Jinja MC will host Ndeje University. Maroons FC are leading the Elgon group with 23 points, while the Saints are topping the Rwenzori group with 26 points.